What is going on, everybody? My name is Fernando Gonzalez, and welcome back to my channel. It's week 5, Mero Monday, guys, and you guys killed it with the questions this week. I have a lot of questions. I'm about to say, like, a curse word, but I don't want to curse in the first 10 seconds of my video. But let's fucking get into it. First question is from Beefinity V, and he asks, what's your opinion on knee sleeves for squats? Would you use them? Personally, I have nothing against knee sleeves for squats. I think if you like have problems with knees and want to keep them warm in between sets, I think they're very important. Honestly, I would use them. I've actually been considering using them because I noticed that my left knee always is kind of weak. But here's the thing, knee sleeves won't make your knees stronger. They'll just keep them warm and they won't get cold. And I guess some people like that. I don't know. I personally would prefer my knees to be warm, but I haven't felt the need to buy knee sleeves yet. But it is something that I've been considering for like, who knows how long now. I've been thinking about it for about a few months already. But I just never got to it because I don't see them as that important. But if you guys want to use knee sleeves, there's nothing wrong with them at all. Next question is from Brian Felix, and he asks, what computer and editing software do you use to edit your videos, bro? Plus he says check out my channel, so if you guys want to go check out his channel, go ahead and do it. Okay, so the computer that I use is just a MacBook like from 2015, like the biggest MacBook, the big like 15 inch I think. And the editing software that I use is Final Cut Pro X, or whatever it's called, Final Cut X. That's what I use. It's pretty simple. It's just like iMovie, just a little bit more like features and stuff. So honestly, I used to use iMovie for the first like 6 months of my channel. So iMovie's fine, but Final Cut is just what I use since I like having those extra features. Next question is from Brian Silva, and he asks, are you following any program right now? What program do you plan to follow after your cut? So currently, guys, I'm on the NSUNS 531 program, which is the primarily powerlifting program, but I incorporate bodybuilding movements, so pretty much it's a power building program for me. So that's the program that I'm on right now, and it's been showing me great results. Even though that I'm cutting, I'm still adding strength every single week and increasing the weight, so I feel good about that. It's a great program, many sets. You gotta have some time in the gym, guys, in order to do this program, since you're doing about 9 sets of your main lift, then about 8 sets of the secondary lift. But after the cut, I just plan to stick to this program and continue it. Actually, I'm also considering doing a primarily hypertrophy program in order to add some more muscle on me, because I noticed that, you know, I don't have a lot of muscle on me right now. I have a lot of strength, but in terms of the muscle mass, I wanna start adding that. So I might focus for like a few, like, maybe 3 months of a hypertrophy program just to get off of the power building and power lifting, guys. Give my body a bit of a break from those stressors and do hypertrophy in order to build the muscle. And overall, that'll also translate to my power lifting when I get back into it. I'm also thinking about doing a meet this year, guys. So depending on like where my strength is, I'll probably do a meet and do a whole video about my prep and everything. So let me know if you guys are looking forward to that, to a future powerlifting meet or a future men's physique show, which I'm also considering doing once I add some muscle, depending where I get. Next question is from Powerlift, and he asks, measure your arms flexed, unflexed for Mero Monday, and what size shirt do you wear? All right, so I gotta go get a tape measure, but to answer that question, I wear a large or medium, depending on how I feel about my day. Like sometimes I don't wanna like be all tight, so I wear a large, or whenever I wanna like show off my lack of muscle, I wear a medium. Okay, I'll be right back, gotta go get that tape measure. Okay, that was a struggle, but it says 17 and a half inches? I doubt that. Are these centimeters? Okay, these are inches. Yeah, about 17 and a half inches, I guess, is the size of my arms. That's probably incorrect. I doubt. Man. I mean, I don't know. It looks like, well, flex, it looks like that's what I am. 17 and a half. Yeah, 17 and a half, it looks like what I am. There you go, that is the measure of my biceps. Also consider that I do have a lot of fat on my arms, so it's not really the size of my muscle, just the size of my arms. Next question is from Master, and he asks, what's your real job? I'm a personal trainer now, and I'm getting paid to train people. You guys didn't know I'm a NASM certified personal trainer, so I consider that my real job, but my primary source of income is from doing Postmates. I just deliver food and get my money that way. Next question is from Jesus Mendoza, and he asks, do you take pre-workout? How do you stay motivated? Yes, I take pre-workout every single day, no matter what day it is. Even if I rest, pre-workout. I'm just kidding. But I do take pre-workout every day. I work out. I just don't get off of it. I need to. It is not healthy for the body. And how do I stay motivated? It's not hard to stay motivated when you love doing what you're doing. Because at the end of the day, if you love doing something, you won't need to find motivation. You'll just wake up and want to do it. So that's pretty much how I'm doing stuff right now. Like I never have to like wake up and be like, oh, gotta get motivated today. It's more like, let's do this, let's go. 1, 2, 3, doing these steps to succeed. And that's how I go about my day. But sometimes like when you feel like down, you don't want to do anything. What I do is I picture myself and I think to myself, okay, how will this help me get to where I want to be? If I feel like it'll help me achieve my goals, I'm gonna do it. And no matter what, I'm gonna do it. But if I feel like it's kind of like unnecessary and not really gonna help me in any way, I don't do it. So let's say like working out on a rest day, I'm like, okay, how is this gonna help me? It's not gonna help me at all. It's gonna probably hinder my success and my progress in working out. So I just don't work out that day. But let's say waking up at 5 a.m. to go to the zoo, I'm like, okay, how is this gonna help me? Okay, look, I'm gonna make a video, record it, get views. That's another video. That's another way for people to reach me and come, get to my channel. That motivates me. That's all I need. And also seeing my progress and seeing like how heavy I could lift that day, that motivates me. Next question is from Beefinity B again. What's up, bro? I love you leaving me questions, man. You're fucking awesome. And he asks, would you fight KSI? Call him out. Yes, I would fight KSI. I would fight him any day. Beat his ass. I would. I'm a big dude. I don't know how big he is, honestly, but I'll beat his ass. No, I'm kidding. Honestly, I see all these videos of people calling out KSI just because it's what's trending and stuff. And like, it is what it is, honestly. I honestly don't care about any YouTube stuff. Like, I don't really pay attention to any of the big YouTubers or what they're doing, like Logan, Jake Paul. I don't care about them at all. So, would I fight KSI? Yeah. I'm not gonna call them out though. Next question comes from EZC and he asks, are you aiming more towards bodybuilding / powerlifting? Okay, I think he meant or, like the slash means or. Okay, I am aiming right now more towards powerlifting because I'm cutting right now and I wanna maintain the strength that I have. But once my cut is finished, I wanna aim more towards bodybuilding. Okay, he also asks, or towards personal training, or towards competition, or towards YouTube. Oh, I didn't read the whole question. Which takes priority if you could list an order of importance, as I have a feeling you're interested in all four, so what is the order? Oh man, okay, sorry for answering your question wrong at first. Okay, I got this. My main focus right now, I think it's tied. I think all four are very important, like personal training, bodybuilding, competitions, or YouTube, but I think competitions is probably like the last one. If I gotta rank them, competitions is 4, so I'll start from the back. So competitions is 4. That's my least, like, main focus. Personal training, okay, look, it's like a 3-way tie. Powerlifting and bodybuilding is like 3, I guess. Personal training is 2, and YouTube is number 1. But it's like a 3-way tie. There's like a tiny bit of gap between them, so I guess that's the way I'll rank them, guys. But it's hard. I love all these things. I'm like focused so hard on all these things. And in terms of competing, I want to do like a powerlifting show. I also want to do a physique show. So my mind is everywhere. I have so many things that I want to do. Next question is from Alex Liv Styles. I thought this was funny. In my physique update, I said I weighed 333 pounds. I got my words mixed up. I was weighing 230, not 333. That's way too heavy. Man, that'd be crazy if I was that big. And the final question is from I Love Bachata, and he asks, quick question, how much cardio should you do while you're bulking? Okay, look, this is what I think. If you're bulking, do as much cardio as you feel fit. But I do suggest to do cardio, guys, especially because when you're bulking, you don't want your heart to get weak. Your heart is still important. That's what cardio does. It trains your heart to get stronger, and you want a strong heart no matter what. Especially if you're gonna get back into a cut, you don't wanna be all sluggish into a cut. Like, you know, like, oh, I gotta get back doing cardio. Also, not only is cardio helpful for your heart, it gives you those extra calories to eat. So like, you can burn 200 calories, you can eat a little more, you know, especially if you like eating. But if you have like trouble gaining weight, I suggest only a little bit of cardio. Because obviously you wanna just measure your calories and make sure you're not burning all your calories and then making it so you're not gonna gain weight since your calories are under your surplus. But yeah, I suggest cardio. And as much as you feel fit, honestly, it depends from person to person. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for today's Mayo Monday questions. I appreciate the support, guys. If you guys want your questions answered, leave in the comment section below. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what questions you guys want answered. Anything, guys, I answer anything, no matter what it is, guys. So I truly appreciate it. I appreciate the support. Leave a like at the video. Leave a dislike if you don't like the video. Leave a comment if you have any questions or have any suggestions. And please subscribe if you want to be up to date with all of my content. Also, quick programming note, guys. I'm doing a review on EVP Extreme, guys. Look forward to that video in about a week. Today was my first day on it. If you guys want to see my update on that, go follow me on Instagram at FranklinGonzalezYT. Remember to follow me on Twitter at FrankGonzalezYT. Follow me on Snapchat, FrankGonzalezYT. You know, say what's up to me, guys. If you guys ever see me, I'm also going to give you guys some stickers. So, peace out.